Good morning, I am Dr. Vijay Prakash, and today once we have completed our wax elimination procedure and we have applied cold mold seal, now the next step is we have to do packing of heat cure resins. So first thing which we need to do is we need to take polymer and monomer in a ratio of 3:1 by volume or 2.5:1 by weight. So you follow the volume, we will take one liquid monomer, take one part of it, and we're going to take three parts of polymer. Add this, just sift the polymer into the monomer like this. Similarly, we are going to have, we'll add more polymer. If you feel there is less of monomer, you can always add more monomer, because it should have, the mix should have a proper polymer and monomer. Whenever we are mixing the polymer and monomer, there are five stages. First is the wet stage, in which the monomer and the polymer is mixing. The second stage is the stringy stage, in which it becomes more, the viscosity of the mix increases and it becomes sticky and stringy. And the third stage is the dough stage. Actually, in the dough stage only we will be doing packing. So according to NADA specification number 12, the dough stage, the time needed for it to achieve dough stage is around less than 40 minutes. But the products which we get in the market these days, it is less than 10 minutes. So we get around 7 to 8 minutes for working. That's the working time in a dough stage. And then you have the sticky stage, and finally you have the stiff stage. Checking whether it is achieved that stage, make sure that it is not in a stringy or a sticky stage. See, so still time is there, we need to wait. It is sticking, you can see some strands coming out, so we need to wait slightly more. Once this, we have a mix which is not showing this stringiness, that then it is in the dough stage, and that is the stage in which we have to do packing. We will check and see.
So it is slightly
light, the dough stage. What we will do, we will take the mix it. Form it in the form of rope, and you apply like this in a horseshoe shaped, in the lower area, in the lower mold, and upper, same thing we are going to do. You're going to apply this, form it in the form of ball, apply it in the center and press this all over. Make sure that there is no place which is left without the resin. You have to apply this like this. just apply a layer. It smoothen whatever you have mixed. Another thing which we need to do is we need to take your plastic sheets. Wet them and you're going to take this plastic sheet and apply it over this. This will be handy when we are doing our trial closure. Like this. Now we'll approximate the both the members of the flask. Seat them nicely. Same thing we are going to do here. Don't force it. Just apply nicely. Hydraulic press, and then we are going to apply not too much of pressure, but we are going to apply pressure. So whatever excess is there, you can see it is flowing out. Can you see this? This is known as flash. We call this as flash, and this needs to be removed. So we need to open this up and again remove the excess. So whatever excess you see all around, very carefully you'll remove. You're going to use not very sharp instrument. You're going to use only a and you're going to just remove blunt instrument you're going to use. You're going to again close it. And trial closure step is repeated till the time you are having flash coming out, the excess material coming out from between the two parts of the flask. So you remove. Remove the excess like this. And this similar procedure is repeated till the time, as I mentioned before, till the time you get excess of material coming out between the two members of the flask. We have done your plastic sheets. We will directly going to assemble these two parts together. Approximate nicely so that you have a good metal to metal contact. We are going to place it on the hydraulic press and again approximate this. Like this. Whatever excess material that you see all around, just remove it, because once curing is done, then this again will interfere. So we place it on a mechanical press and we can see there is a good metal to metal contact between both the members, and there is no excess flash which is coming out. So once we have done this, we have applied pressure, then we place it on our regular clamp, and then it is ready for we'll do bench curing for around 45 minutes and then it will be ready for curing of our dentures. So we place it on our clamp And now it is, so once we are sure that it is right, and don't apply too much of force, because excess of force means you are going to damage the cast, and then you'll not get a proper processes as we are expecting. So once this is done, now it is ready to be put for curing. We will wait for bench curing around 45 minutes to 1 hour, and then we will start the process of curing. With this, we come to an end for our packing procedure. Thank you for watching the video.